Now, I would like to give some range for the communication purpose. Now, here we take some frequency range, preferably from the micro radio waves. Here I will say that range of frequency and its name, range of frequencies along with their names. First one is MF frequency. MF means middle frequency. When the frequency ranges from 300 kilohertz to 3000 kilohertz. 300 kilohertz to 3000 kilohertz, it is megahertz frequency. HF high frequency ranges from 3 megahertz to 30 megahertz. Very high frequency, it is nothing but range 30 megahertz to 300 megahertz. Then ultra high frequency, UHF, ultra high frequency, 300 megahertz to 3000 megahertz. Super high frequency, SHF, it is the range, it is of range 3000 megahertz to 30,000 megahertz. And last one, extra high frequencies, 30 gigahertz to 300 gigahertz. So here range of frequency is like this: megahertz frequency, high frequency, very high frequency, ultra high frequency, super high frequency, and extra high frequencies. These are some ranges useful in radio communication. So for ground wave propagation, here I write, for ground wave propagation, the frequency in the range 3 megahertz to 30 megahertz, they are useful. For sky wave propagation, sky wave propagation, very high frequency in the range 3 megahertz to 300 megahertz, they are useful. And in space wave communication, space wave propagation or communication, we use ultra high frequency in the range 300 megahertz to 3000 megahertz. So these are some ranges which are useful in communication purposes. So here, after classification of the frequencies, the method to produce these frequencies are nothing but electronic devices and LC circuits. Acceleration, where the acceleration of charged particles are made to radiate the electrical energy, electromagnetic energy, they are known as radio waves. So these radio waves are produced. Now we look at the here we have seen the types of electromagnetic waves, the range of electromagnetic waves, the purpose of electromagnetic waves, and the use of electromagnetic waves. Now the useful part of the electromagnetic waves for communication is the radio waves, and next one is microwaves. So they are used for the communication. What is communication? So giving some information to somebody and receiving answer from that somebody is nothing but called as communication. Maybe type of information, maybe type of some photos, maybe in the form of some data, or maybe some work. So research work, this is the message and when message is passed from one person to another person, it is one way communication. And when it is again regain that message from answer of that message from the other person, it is called as the complete communication. So for the complete communication, we require the two main parts. One is called as transmitter and another is called as receiver. And the channel between these two is necessary. It is the essential part of the communication system. So communication is nothing but the giving and taking, receiving the information through some channel, proper channel, and that communication can be made with the help of the electromagnetic waves. So this is the tremendous use of electromagnetic energy or radiation. So before going to the actual how the waves are propagated and how the waves are used for the communication, let us see the basic idea about the atmosphere of Earth. We write here atmosphere of Earth. So Earth, we suppose that Earth is a spherical in shape, not exactly round shape, but it is some hot spherical in shape. So the Earth is surrounded by gaseous layers, and these gaseous layer, they are protecting Earth's surface from direct radiations coming from solar system. So this gaseous layer is known as atmosphere. This is known as atmosphere. It is nothing but gaseous envelope surrounded by the Earth. It is surrounded around the Earth, known as atmosphere. The layers of atmospheres are different. There are five layers: troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, ionosphere and exosphere. So I write particularly, first one is troposphere. First layer of atmosphere is troposphere. Second one is stratosphere. Third one is mesosphere. Fourth one is ionosphere. And last one is known as exosphere. Now here the five layers are, we have seen, the troposphere is the innermost envelope of gas around the Earth. Second one is stratosphere. It is also known as biosphere because it consists of some water molecules and living organisms, micro living organisms. Mesosphere contains only gases and ionosphere contains free electrons. Exosphere is the topmost or outermost envelope of the Earth's atmosphere. Now, about all these spheres or layers of the atmosphere, we have some information like this. We have a small chart again here. And we introduce all our information in this chart. Troposphere is nothing but the innermost layer of the Earth. Here we write as a Earth surface. Earth's surface we take as a zero point reference. So this is 0 kilometer, and up to 12 kilometer, the distance between surface of Earth and the upper layer, this distance of about 12 kilometer is known as a troposphere. Then from troposphere 12 kilometer to 50 kilometer, this distance is occupied by the another layer known as stratosphere. Again from stratosphere to 80 kilometer, 50 to 80 kilometer, the third one layer is mesosphere. And from 80 to 250 kilometer, here starts ionosphere. Here actually the boundary of ionosphere begins, and at 250 kilometer it is said that D layer starts, D layer of atmosphere starts at 250 kilometer, then E layer, then F1 layer, F2 layer are some layers up to 400 kilometers. This is the range of ionosphere. Now mesosphere is the middle one, and between mesosphere and stratosphere there is a bulk of ozone gas, and therefore it is also known as ozonosphere. This distance, it is identified as a ozonosphere. Between the mesosphere and stratosphere, upper layer is ozonosphere. The ultraviolet rays coming from sun, they are mostly absorbed by the ozonosphere, and therefore harmful rays are protected by ozonosphere, and we have no such type of damage directly receiving from the sunlight. Now here I would like to give the electron density. What are the contents? Troposphere contains mainly dust particle, then smoke particles, water vapors and some suspended particles. So dust, smoke, water vapors, they are compositions of the troposphere. Stratosphere is nothing but also known as biosphere. It is also known as biosphere, and it contains mostly gases like nitrogen, sulfur, ammonia, etc. Then in case of mesosphere, it is also gas layer. It contains also gases, gas molecules. And in ionosphere, there is a large concentration of free electrons. Large electrons of free electrons. Now I would like to give a short brief that electron density, how electron density varies and with respect to time. Now we see the temperature and electron density. Temperature theta and electron density like sigma in per meter cube. The temperature of ionosphere ranges from 180 to 300 Kelvin. Temperature of mesosphere, it is ranges from 180 to 290 Kelvin. Again, stratosphere ranges in temperature as 220 to 280 Kelvin, and troposphere 220 to 290 Kelvin. What is the electron density in the most part of the ionosphere? In D layer particularly, we refer electron density in D layer as 10 to the power 9 electron per meter cube. In case of E layer, electron density is 5 into 10 raised to 11 per meter cube. In case of F1 and F2 layer, it is about 8 into 10 raised to 11 per meter cube. So in this way, we have electron density in different layers of atmosphere. The Earth is surrounded by gas layers, and the surrounding the earth. As we move from earth towards outer side, the gas density decreases but ion density increases, and these are helpful in communication system. When we see the propagation of waves, we here apply the properties of waves or the phenomena of waves, like reflection of waves, refraction of waves, interference of waves or superposition of waves. Similarly, other type of properties of waves, they are applied while propagating the waves through different layers of atmosphere. So here we have a brief idea about the atmosphere of Earth and troposphere, very close to surface of Earth or ground, it is close to ground, stratosphere, mesosphere, all these layers play an important role while the waves are sent for the communication purpose from transmitter to receiver. So with this a brief introduction to electromagnetic spectrum and atmospheric layers, we have a short break, and after that break we will continue the types of modes of communication, and then we shall see some examples of electromagnetic waves and some multiple choice questions based on this topic. Till then, we take a small break. Thank you very much.